Yeah, I mean, it's a number of reasons. I mean, we have been seeing hardening markets in global insurance and reinsurance markets for quite some time, and we are happy that this trend continues. One of the reasons, for example, is that losses have been quite significant over the last years already, especially in the natural catastrophe area. But then, of course, also COVID-19 comes along with a lot of uncertainty from many of our clients. And in times of higher uncertainty, protection by a big and strong reinsurer is something they're looking for.
Christoph, very interesting. I recall back in the third quarter, maybe as we wrapped up second quarter numbers, you were expressing real caution about the prospects for significant fallout from COVID-19. As we come into this year and look at your first quarter numbers, it very much looks as though the worst didn't happen. Could you just talk to us about how you're now viewing the potential liabilities from COVID-19 going forward? Do you think this was an unfortunate expression, but a bullet dodged?
Well, I would put it a little bit differently. I mean, what we see is that this year's COVID claims are significantly lower than what we had last year. That's something we expected very much from the very beginning. I think what we see is globally measures are really now taking effect, and all these vaccinations in mature markets clearly have a positive impact. And therefore, we assume from the very beginning that the COVID losses this year will be very much pronounced in the first and second quarter, but much lower than in the future, because we will all fighting that disease and successfully, and that makes me very happy.
Yeah, obviously, though, the course of the disease is unpredictable, and we keep talking about new variants that require additional steps by governments and pharmaceutical companies, and even countries where we thought largely the disease was suppressed, like Japan, have witnessed flare-ups. How much visibility do you feel you really have on these liabilities?
Well, I mean, how much visibility do we have to developments which are in the future? Limited, I would say, because the uncertainty in the future is clearly our business, so we have to prepare for each of these potential developments. But what I can say is that our exposure is much lower than last year, so the potential financial impact of any detrimental scenario is much less than it has been last year.